Obtain a mannequin head from the core laboratory. It is important to use the same mannequin for all the exercises. Observe the knobs, which allow the mannequin to open and close as well as to adjust the mannequin occlusion. Acquire the largest mandibular stock tray and try it on the mannequin. Warm the stock tray using the Bunsen burner to expand the lingual flange of the tray. Use care not to overheat the tray. Place red rope wax along the borders of the tray. Apply a liberal amount of tray adhesive to the tray, being sure to cover the lateral borders of the tray. Use 3 to 4 scoops of alginate. Using your finger, apply the impression material to the occlusal surfaces of the teeth. Additionally, fill the vestibule with impression material. Load the tray and seat the tray onto the model. After the material has set, remove the tray in one motion. A neater cast will result if impression material covers the tongue space. Wrap the impression in a wet paper towel. Try in the maxillary tray. Add wax to the borders of the maxillary tray. Build up the palate of the tray with red rope wax. Place a liberal amount of tray adhesive on the tray, wax, and external border of the tray. Seat the tray. Hold the impression still until the impression is set. Notice the extrusion of material through the holes in the tray. This helps to retain the impression within the tray. Failure to adhere to the tray will result in a badly distorted impression. Remove the tray in one motion. Observe the impression for defects. Use the double pour method to fabricate diagnostic casts with yellow stone. Trim the base of the cast. The cast is 14 to 16 millimeters thick, and the occlusal plane is level with the bench top. It is not necessary to index the casts at this time. Please observe all laboratory safety precautions. Protective eyewear should be worn whenever rotary instruments are in use.